So since you've landed on this video, chances are you already carrying two phones today, maybe either in your pocket or in front of you, or you're someone who is about to carry two phones. Well, in this video, I'm going to tell you what dual SIM is, I'm going to tell you how it can benefit you, and we're even going to go through the activation process. Let's get started. What is going on, everyone? It is Mike, and this is tech247.tv. We bring you the best in unboxing and product reviews so you can make informed buying decisions. Here on this channel, we do the analysis on the various bits and bytes that transcend technology, only to find their way into your pocket. So if you like product reviews and unboxing videos, you really need to subscribe. We do this every week, and I think you're gonna like it. Just a reminder that our giveaway for hitting 100 subscribers is going on. We have the second of three giveaways for the Apple Animoji Kaleidoscope T-shirt that comes from the company store at Apple's Infinite Loop campus in Cupertino. This, in addition to a wireless Qi charging pad from Mophie, will go to one lucky winner. So if you like collectible items and you want to one-up one of your nerd friends, you want to make sure that you are subscribed to the channel, that you dropped a like on this video, and that you are following us on social, because that is where we're going to announce the winner. Now let's talk about those phones. So if you're a bit like me, you might find yourself needing to carry a second cell phone on a daily basis. It could be for work, maybe it's for on-call, maybe it's even for while you travel abroad. Well, the friction here is that everything you do because you have a second cell phone is twice the effort. I mean, you gotta charge two phones, you need accessories for two phones, you need service plans for two phones. You get my drift, right? Well, the 2018 iPhones, which include the iPhone XS, XS Max, and the iPhone XR, are dual SIM capable. Now, this isn't the same thing as having a phone number from Skype or Google Voice. These are over-the-top services, or OTT VoIP services, and these services still require you to have an internet connection. This means that the phone itself is capable of having two phones' numbers assigned to it, and no matter what phone number someone calls, it's gonna ring a single device. This is what the standard bodies commonly refer to as dual SIM, dual standby. So no matter what phone number someone dials, if they call that phone, it's gonna ring your device. And what's great is that this functionality is even extended to your Apple Watch Series 3 or Series 4 if you have cellular enabled, right? That's another bonus. I know you might be thinking to yourself, hey Mike, this is 2018, how is this even new? Well, this is the first time in the US that someone's been able to buy a dual SIM phone, even at scale, right? And more broadly speaking, for those people who are watching outside of the US, Apple getting behind dual SIM, dual standby means that your carrier, right, is more likely to implement the network support that's needed for this technology. So let's talk about the possible use cases for this. The first use case is exactly like mine. You have two phones and you want to consolidate down to one physical device. In this scenario, I only need to carry one device, so this means that I can possibly resell or re-gift that second device to a friend or family member. I don't need to carry insurance on that second phone. I don't need to carry Apple Care on that second phone. I don't need to buy accessories for that second phone. So there is an incremental amount of savings that I can go ahead and realize by activating this. Now, I still need to pay for my monthly service plan, because I was paying for my monthly service plan before, and I still have that second telephone number on this single phone. In the second scenario is where you have one single phone and you want to activate some data plan for international travel. Nobody wants to get screwed from their carrier for high data roaming rates while they're traveling abroad. So what you could do is you could activate a data only plan from a carrier such as TruPhone or GigSky right from the comfort of your hotel room using an app. There's no misunderstanding, there's no understanding the local language, there's no currency conversion. The third scenario is very much like the second scenario, but instead of getting a data-only plan, you need to get a local number. So here there are a number of different carriers that support eSIM all over the world, and Apple keeps a list of those growing carriers on its support page, which I'm going to link in the video description below. So the same benefits apply in scenario 3 as scenario 2. You will be able to activate a secondary line from the comfort of your location without needing to worry about misunderstanding, currency conversion, or any type of those problems. So let's go ahead and set up our device. In this example, I'm gonna be using GigSky, which is a prepaid data service provider. As I mentioned previously, that it is easy as downloading an app, or as straightforward as downloading an app. After you've installed the app and registered, you're presented with several different pricing options based on the geographical region that you are traveling in. Simply choose how much data you want and how long you want the data for, and you're presented with a checkout total. And since GigSky supports Apple Pay, I authenticate with my face and I purchase my plan using my local currency. Now that we have our second cellular plan added to our device, let's take a look at what actually transpired. To manage our cellular accounts tied to the device, we're gonna go ahead and navigate to settings, and then we're gonna go to cellular. On this screen, we've seen the following items. The first thing we see is the label that I assigned to that second cellular plan, which is secondary. Next, we see that the line is enabled. Third, we see that the network selection is to GigSky. Fourth, if LTE is enabled. And finally, fifth, if and when we want to remove the cellular plan from our phone. Now, if you look closely at the cell signal bars, they look a little bit different. That's because those signal bars are showing a service for both your primary and your secondary cellular plan. If you open up Control Center, you can see the delineation between the different networks with their respective names. So that is it for me today. Who plans or who has already activated dual SIM on their iPhone? Let me know in the comments below. Hit like, hit subscribe, and consider entering in that contest because you probably have a good chance of winning. We'll talk to you in the next one.